Hi, welcome back. I want to do a response to all the wonderful comments and feedback people gave me on my initial video about my LG washing machine. That video had a bunch of restrictions on it as it was the pitch video for the Holman Prize, but today I want to give you a little bit more information, a little bit more detail, and respond to all of you. So first of all, I want to talk about the knob on the washing machine. So this knob is currently the machine is off. This knob, you should be able to hear it click, click, clicking, does have clicks. The problem is it's what we call, it's an endless loop. So you can start somewhere and you never get to the end. You always keep going around, and that's, you know, for convenience for a sighted person. But for a blind person, if you're counting and you miscount, you're just going to keep going into an endless loop. So if I turn it on, it does always start at the same cycle. It can be labeled what the cycles are, and I'm going to have a friend come over and do that for me because he's actually found a really good way of doing it for his wife, so I'm going to get him to duplicate that for me. And what he did, and this is from description only, is that he put a column of text down on the right. And that is every time you turn to the right, you hit the first one, next one, second one, then back to normal. And then he put a column of text on the left. So if I wanted to go to the second one down on the left, I'd go to the left twice. Right now, I'd have to memorize all those. And frankly, you know, my head can't memorize all those. And the other part of it is we're able to download onto this machine different programs. So if I've downloaded something onto the machine, that may change that. So maybe braille labeling it won't be a good idea. So let's move to the touch panel that we spoke about. And there we go. You see, I've already touched it and started doing something, and I don't know what I've done. But my husband has gone through and put some tactile markers on this machine for me since last week. When I did the video last time, the machine was brand new and we hadn't done it yet. So what we've done is the panel itself has a seam, and that seam goes around the entire panel so I can feel it. I'm betting that's so that if it breaks, they can actually replace that panel on its own. But that means it's easy for me to feel where the edges of the panel are, and I can just track down the edge of it and feel the tape lines that my husband put on here for me. So there is a line, a line, a line. And I'm on the left-hand side. If I go along the top here now, I can feel the line that designates the edge of the buttons on the left side. And it's a straight line all the way down the panel. And there I go and hitting a button. I don't know what I've hit. And then there's a line all the way across the top of the buttons on the bottom there. And then there's another line to the left of the buttons on the right-hand side. And then the edge of the panel. So this has framed out the buttons for me, and now I have to memorize. And again, memory is getting harder the older I get. So I have to memorize what each of these buttons do. So far the buttons I've memorized is that the second one down on the left-hand side is the one I need to use the app remotely. And I know that I have to hold that button in for 3 seconds. I'll demonstrate that in a moment. And if I come over to the right-hand side here, the top button is Turbo Wash. So if I press that, I don't know if that's turned Turbo Wash on or off, because I may have already pressed it at some point. And then underneath that is where a button that's supposed to set the amount of laundry detergent that I'm going to use. And this machine has an auto dispenser for laundry detergent, and that's something we really wanted because we have a cleaning lady who comes in and does the laundry, and some of the cleaning ladies we've had in the past use too much laundry soap. So we wanted the machine to actually control how much was used so they didn't use too much and the clothes don't get over soapy. And then it has a button underneath that that is for fabric softener. And we don't actually use fabric softener. None of our clothes is the kind of clothes that you'd want to use fabric softener on, and we think that it actually makes the clothes feel funny. And so we don't want to use fabric softener. And while we were marking the machine, was the first time we discovered we could actually turn the fabric softener off. Because so far, every time we've used the machine, it keeps telling us that we need to add fabric softener, even though we don't have any and don't want it. But again, if I push that button, I don't know if it's increasing or decreasing or what setting I've set it to, if it's set to zero, if it's set to maximum, what have you. It's now beeping at me. I don't know why it's beeping at me. A whole bunch of stuff like that. There's so much more that could be done with the app, one would hope. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell it to engage the app by, let's restart here from scratch. And I'm going to go to our panel, find that second button down on the left. And you see how careful I have to be to find that button. I'm holding it in for 3 seconds. And the machine clicked and it acknowledged by clicking. So I'm assuming I held it down to long enough. And I have my Android phone in my hand here.
Device unlocked, 6:53 p.m.
And I'm going to try and see if I can change the temperature of the wash in the app.
Web view. Back button.
So I'm in a web view. It says back.
More options. Button.
More options.
Start button.
I can start the machine.
Nope. Temp. Tap cold, cold, warm, hot, extra hot.
And it says temp. Tap cold, cold, extra hot. And that makes no sense. That's all it said. If I tap it.
Web view.
I go into another web view.
Button. More options. But washer. In.
And now I go back to the screen I was on previously, which says washer in.
Extra rinse zero. Turbo wash on.
Turbo wash is on. I'm going to turn the turbo wash off just to see if I can do it.
Extra rinse zero. Turbo wash on.
And it still says it's on. So maybe let's try playing with the machine here and seeing the button I know that's turbo wash.
Steam off. Turbo wash on.
Let's try it again. One beep, hopefully. Nope, 2 beeps. Nope, it's beeping twice because, of course, now that I'm using the app, I can't change the settings.
Steam off. Double tap and hold to wash off. Double tap and hold to long press. Steam off. Cold wash off.
Cold wash off.
Pre-wash off.
Pre-wash off.
Delay wash button.
Delay wash.
Start button out of.
I can start.
No next default. Delay wash button in. Pre-wash off. Double tap and hold. Cold wash off. Double tap and hold to long press.
So I'm going to go cold wash to see if I can change it to hot.
Pre-wash off. Delay wash. But start button. Web view. Back button. Washer. Heading 1. More options. Button. Washer. Extra rinse 0. Turbo wash on. Steam off. Cold wash off. Steam off. Cold wash off.
Nope.
Double tap and hold to long press.
So the app has good labels, which is really, really surprising. But the labels are meaningless because I can't activate them with the screen reader. Let's talk a little bit about some of the comments about me personally. Why I move my head so much and why my eyes move the way they do, that's because of the blindness condition I have. Makes my brain think that it's trying to see, so it's making me move my head up and down to trying to focus. Even though I'm totally blind, I've got the neurological response to try and actually still focus. So I'm moving my eyes and moving my head to try and focus on things. Sometimes it's in response to sound, other times it's just completely involuntary where my brain is trying to get me to focus on something even though I can't see it. Why I didn't buy a cheaper machine that just had dials? Well, and this is a really important, sensitive point to me. As a blind person, we don't need to be delegated to a second-class citizen where we have to buy a cheaper, less effective, less efficient machine. If you look at the Consumer Reports ratings, the cheaper machines do exist, yes, but they don't clean the clothes as well, they don't have the same feature sets, you know, they don't have the ability to do delay wash. I live with somebody else who can use those features, and frankly, I'd say probably 75% of the time, somebody else is actually using the machine. But still, there's no reason why, as a blind person, I shouldn't have the right to buy the highest end machine if that's what I want. By telling me that I needed to buy the cheaper, older model tells me that you don't think I have the same rights to the comforts and luxuries of life that an able-bodied person does. And that's just plain discrimination. Other comments that people left, you know, why hasn't anybody done this before? I don't know why anybody hasn't done this before. This is something I'm going to try and do, and I'm going to get other blind people to help review things as well, because multiple perspectives are the best thing. A couple of people have asked me if LG is going to replace this machine for me. No, LG is not interested in replacing this machine for me. Although if you start harassing them, maybe they would. I don't think so though. What other kind of things am I going to be reviewing? I will be reviewing everything from coffee pots to vacuum cleaners to robot vacuum cleaners. And the reviews are going to be very long and very extensive. What you just saw here on this washing machine is only a miniature review of what we could do with the washing machine review. Once I have it fully labeled, we'll talk about how to get it labeled. You know, the other part of it is I'm also lucky enough to have somebody to help me label it. What if a blind person doesn't have that? So, you know, maybe they have to hire a task rabbit or something like that to come in. You know, I can at least help them figure out exactly what to tell the task rabbit to do for the markings and labels. That would be part of the reviews. Workarounds, you know, review of the app, talking about how the app works on both Android and iOS. Different things like that will be part of those reviews. We're going to try and get a couple of different perspectives on some of the more popular items, because every blind person is different and we want people to actually know how to use things more differently. We're going to talk about how you can use assistant speakers to help. So for example, LG does actually have a Google Home and Alexa integration with this machine. I haven't learned how to do that yet, but I have a feeling it's probably going to be pretty bad, because we do have an LG air conditioner that we bought during the hottest part of the summer. And that air conditioner, when I use my speakers with it, all I can do is turn it off and turn it on. If I say I want to turn off the base temperature or turn down the base temperature or turn up the base temperature, it says heat is not enabled. So if I, you know, want to change the temperature from 21 degrees Celsius so that it maybe starts cooling at 25 degrees Celsius because I'm being energy conscious, I can't do that. I have to somehow get somebody else to use the remote control and do that. So the speaker, you know, the speaker integration, nice idea, didn't work so well. All right, well, please leave more comments, ask more questions. Hopefully I answered some of the comments you had, and we'll see in a couple of months if we get the Holman Prize and we can get started on this project. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to hit subscribe and like the pitch video, please. You can like this video too, but the pitch video is the one that I need your vote on. Thank you.